Very exciting. Today we got our first look at the brand new Disney 100 Peter Pan set. It's a diorama style build based off of the 1953 classic movie Peter Pan. The set number for this is 43232. The price is apparently going to be either $60 or $65, and it's going to have 466 parts. The main build of the set features the clock tower, otherwise known as Big Ben, in London, as Peter, Wendy, and Tinkerbell fly out of this nighttime skyline. As I said before, it is a diorama-style build, so you get the nice black border going around it, although the Disney 100 logo on the front does look a little bit weird when it's positioned like that in gray. Of course, the building, the river, and everything else in the scene is all light to dark blue, which looks really pretty and obviously signifies nighttime. Now let's take a look at the figures. Included in this set, we have Peter Pan, Tinkerbell, and Wendy. The Peter Pan and Tinkerbell seem to be reuses. Peter Pan and Tinkerbell have been in the 4+ train for Disney 100 that came out earlier this year, while Wendy is indeed an exclusive to this set. One of the main things that I would like to point out is that this set costs $65 for a very small diorama piece, and while it looks really nice, you're getting two non-exclusive figures in a only three-figure set. This is the scene in the movie that this set is supposed to represent, and I can see why some people are not at all happy that Tinkerbell is a full-size minifigure, as she would be the perfect size for a microfigure. In my opinion, something that would have made this set a lot more manageable would have been making Tinkerbell a microfigure while putting John and Michael Darling, Wendy's brothers, into this scene as they should be. I definitely understand that it is a smaller diorama, and you can't just stick in two more figures, as they simply wouldn't fit. However, the set only has 466 parts, and it costs $65 or something. So for that price, either make it a little bit bigger, or just give us the figures anyway and stick them onto those clear pieces like they did with Tinkerbell. Either way, it looks like a really fantastic set, however that price is just atrocious to me. I thought this would be like a $35 to $40 set tops, and that's honestly what it looks like, but $60 or $65 is really bad. I hope that they adjust the price like they've been doing for a couple of sets lately, like the 332nd Battle Pack, and also the Batcave. I personally definitely want this set, however there's no shot that I will pay $65 MSRP for it. Let me know what you think in the comments. Remember, like and subscribe. Bengals Bricks.